Dividing heads start at about $400, but this one didn't cost me anything since it's made with materials I had laying around. And here's how it's made. ¾-inch with 1/4-inch wall tube serves as a headstock and tailstock. And 2½-inch aluminum bar stock is for the locking collar. After layout, holes are marked and drilled. Cool tool is used for most of my operations. My punch is handy for making oblong slots. A piece of aluminum serves as a stripper to prevent distorting the aluminum. This little piece of aluminum will wind up being the pointer. It's easier to hold on to small pieces in this corner notcher rather than the shear. And that's all there is to making a pointer. 1/2-inch stress proof is used for the headstock and tailstock shaft. It's cut to length and then flat sawmilled milled. A 40,000th thick groove is machined for the eclipse. This aluminum shaft locking collar is being center drilled and then drilled for a 1/2-inch shaft undersized so that a reamer, which is being shown now, can give a perfectly 1/2-inch diameter hole. Then we're relieving a bit of aluminum for the eclip to fit in. A flat is milled for the tension screw to perch against. And then it's drilled for a 3/8/16-inch threaded knob assembly. Using a slotting saw, a 3/16-inch cut is made to the center. This is cut parallel to the flat we just previously machined. And all the parts are now assembled. Now I'm working on the mandrel attachment ends. These are first center drilled to get everything nice and concentric. And then they're undrilled undersized 3/8 inch. And then they are reamed to exactly 3/8 inch all the way through. And then next they are drilled 1/2-inch undersized about halfway through and then reamed again. And this is done for both ends. To drill and tap perfectly centered and square holes, They're held in this dress press jig on my drill press. That way they are perfectly centered on the hole, and they can be drilled and tapped in the same position. This is the indexing wheel. It's made of PVC. A 1/2 inch wide strip of paper is attached with tape at one end, and then it's marked and cut where the ends meet. To divide this strip into 19 equal divisions, a starting and ending line is drawn at each end of the strip. Then a ruler is angled between these starting and ending marks above this paper strip using easy divisions on the ruler. A mark is made at each of these divisions. In this case, I'm using agate. Rubber cement is being used to attach the paper strip to this PVC indexing wheel. The dividing head is now ready to be put together. To see this device in action, watch part 2 of this video, where we machine a gear and make an angle plate and also an indexing plate. And thanks for watching.